question is from Amrita Chatterjee, and the topic she is going to speak, that is brand equity, brand loyalty, and consumer readiness to play a linear approach of measurement. I love to know, because as a researcher, you know, when I started my PhD long back in 2002, and the topic which I had chosen was enterprise resource planning. So ERP was, you know, a very burgeoning term at that time, and people had thought of, you know, ERP is a very different term, how you're going to do research. So when, you know, when presenter comes over here and he, you know, starts with the topic, I love to know, like, you know, why you chosen this topic, because जब आप कोई टॉपिक चूज करते हैं, अगर मान लीजिए कोई मूवी बनती है, उसका कोई टाइटल भी बनता है, तो लॉट ऑफ यू नो द बैक ऑफिस एक्टिविटीज आर देयर. सो आई वांट टू नो दैट लाइक व्हाई यू चूजिंग दिस टाइटल. नॉट
एक्चुअली
रिलेटेड टू ईआरपी, इट्स समथिंग नॉट रिलेटेड टू ईआरपी. दिस इज जस्ट एन एग्जांपल, बिकॉज़ व्हेन आई हैव टेकन ईआरपी, सो आई हैव डन लॉट ऑफ रिसर्च, यू नो. Generally what happens, you know, you do a lot of research, you find out the gap, then you conclude, and then you come to the title, you know. Because choosing a title is not, you know, it's a very, you know, tedious.
The main job.
Yeah, it's a main job. Because already, the moment you choose a topic, you come to know that, you know, you're moving in this direction, your research will go in that direction. But you know, up to 10-20% you're able to know that, you know, your research is moving in this direction. The moment you start asking the question from the respondent, then you accumulate it, then you come to a conclusion. But more or less, you know, you are landing
at the place. Research is probabilistic, it's not written.
Yes.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Amrita Chatterjee. I am doing my PhD work under Dr. Ishital Aidi in University of Kalyani. Okay, now why I have chosen brand equity, brand loyalty, and consumer's willingness to pay as a linear approach of measurement. First, my guide told me that you should work on something related to brand. Actually, she is the expert on that particular area. So I have gone through so many research topics and all. Then I have identified that brand equity is something which can give edge to the manufacturer or to the company. So I have selected two, three main research papers which can be the guiding one. And I took them to the sellers, simple sellers who are at least graduate and who can understand English. And I was there to help them out. So I told them, go through these papers and you just told me how you can incorporate this in your real world. They go through those papers and they told that it is not at all understandable by us. So that moment I told ma'am that I will try to develop something which should be accessible by all. So this was my main objective. And next one is in brand equity measurement, Young and Rubicon are there. They took a lot of money for this consultation, as a consultation charge. So there was something in my mind that the new entrepreneurs should be able to use my model, because it should be free, available free, and it is not prioritized. So in 1991, when market liberalization is there, so many players introduced in Indian FMCG market, like HUL, ITC, and P&G. And I have chosen actually few shampoo brands after primary or pilot study. These are the Sunsilk, Pantene, Garnier, Clinique, Head & Shoulder, L'Oreal, Tresemme, Dove, Vatika, and Patanjali are considered as the prime brands by the sellers and as well as by the consumers. Okay, now background of the study. First, it's started with Acres work, and then it is by Kellers, and last my guiding paper is by Yoa and Dantu, which is in 2001. They have constructed a multi-dimensional scaling to measure brand equity of a particular product. Okay, now the research gap. In research gap, we have found out that for particular FMCG product, no model is there. And you and Dondu have mentioned that while culture is changed, while product category is changed, or while the service is changed, brand equity is also changing. So we have selected FMCG product as our research area or category, and then we have surveyed in Kolkata's market. Now in Kolkata, every landmark is called a more. We have actually I actually stand over a more, and I started collecting primary data. It's completely random one. Whoever was coming and whoever is ready to give me answer, I have taken response from them only. So my objectives, which I have already told you. Now the variables, which are actually identified by the consumers or by the sellers, I have first taken them, and then I gone through the literatures, previous literatures, and I defined them. In this case, I want to tell you something. Price. Price is actually defined as the hike in present price of a brand in a said period of time. This is not the definition of price. But when I am going to conduct a primary research, people are saying that how you are considering the price. They are saying that price hike is the main prime concern for us. That's why I have defined price is like that. Now, data and methodology. First, I will. I don't know the actual population of Kolkata or suburbs area, so I have taken a formula to define my sample size, which is for infinite population, and I have taken 500. If you want to calculate, then you will find that 500 is adequate sample. Then sampling procedure, but it's not my. These are the demographic variables. Now reliability, because if I am conducting a study and my result, I am not able to say that yes, my result is reliable. To support that sentence, I will have to do some statistical analysis. So here the reliability study, where Cronberg alpha is 0.985, which is quite a significant value. And the result which we will get, now I can say that it will be a reliable one. Next is normality. As I have collected the response in interval scale, so normality study is required. Here are the skewness and kurtosis measures, but I'm not going through that. Only the histogram will tell you that it's absolutely normal with few kurtosis measure. Now brand equity analysis and the result. First, we have taken 500 sellers to tell about response about brand loyalty. Like for them, it is repeated purchase. They don't understand the jargon brand loyalty. For them, it is repeated purchase. And then for brand equity, we have constructed our first equation based on brand equity and brand loyalty. It is a simple linear regression. Next, our hypothesis is, null hypothesis is, there is no relationship between brand loyalty and consumers' willingness to pay. Now, our main concern is about consumers' willingness to pay. Whether I want to pay for Tresemme or I want to pay for Dove. It is entirely my own decision. So here is a Pearson correlation we have done first. Now it has a high correlation of 0.971. That means they are positively correlated. In the next section, we have gone through again for a linear regression process. It is a simple one, and here all the variables are significant, and the adjusted R-square value is 0.943. That means the predictor variable is able to describe the dependent variable well enough. Now here are few null hypotheses which we have considered, and for that we have just gone through we have just done a linear regression, multiple regression model, which is again a simple one. And again, the adjusted R square value is quite good. Now we have constructed our third equation, which is based on consumer's willingness to pay and as well as few variables which are identified by the consumers at the time of primary survey. Yes. Now, simple one, subtracting the value of brand loyalty in the primary equation, and we got the brand equity measurement equation, which is our equation number 5, where there are so many variables are identified. In between, we have just dropped self-image, because in FMCG, in case of FMCG product, we are not concerned about self-image, because only FMCG, in case of FMCG products, like I am purchasing a car, that only I can demonstrate or I can display as my social status. In case of shampoo or anything, it's like toiletry uses, so we can't show our economic status or self-image by using that. So we have dropped that variable. And the conclusion, we have constructed a guiding equation. Any one of you, or I can also put the values about any shampoo brand on that particular variables, on that particular guiding equation, and we can have a brand equity score, which is actually comparable with so many other brands. So this is that's all from my side.
Thank you. Any observation from
I have a question.
Yes, sir.
You know, brand buyers,
yes,
you know, how long people rely on an average to make any kind of
decision? Yes, sir, definitely.
For example, you have a Mexico product. Somebody has switched out for the month. You may rely for a year on one particular product. Do you have an estimate of the study on an average of people behavior?
If you go through our equation, you will see that brand switch have a negative coefficient. So while we are putting value on the guiding equation, brand switching value will definitely be subtracted from the actual point. So it has a negative coefficient. So we have considered brand switching.
Is there a kind of period in the interval, 1 year, 2 years?
Sir, we have actually considered 5 repeated purchases as example.
I have a question. The question is, the seller and the buyers, is the same or the other?
No, those are different, because perspective
so
is different.
So have you considered the factors both for the same?
Yes, factors were same, but the question type were mainly different.
So the factors for sellers and the factors for buyers different references also.
Actually, when I am selling something, I will consider the buyer's point of view. Like, to me, profit is something, but if you can ask me about price. So, if I am asking, for example, I am asking a seller how buyers are considering the price. So, he is telling that while price hike is there, they are actually dropping that product or something. It's like that. It's one-to-one interview and primary data collection method. So, we have used actually for our simplification of the process, we have used same.
So, there's something known as the shelf value of the product. As soon as
So in the lunch time, some more colleagues are there, we will discuss. So now I am inviting another.
Sir, may I?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.